The Thanatos Syndrome by Walker Percy. This book is read by David HIlder. The following material appears on the book's dust jacket. Dr. Tom Moore. For some time now, I have noticed that something strange is occurring in our region. I have noticed it both in patients I have treated and in ordinary encounters with people. His region is the parish of Feliciana, Louisiana, where he was born and bred. Now on parole in the custody of fellow doctors Bob Camo and Max Gottlieb, Dr. Tom proceeds cautiously. The unusual sexual behavior in some women patients, their bizarre movements and loss of inhibition, presenting themselves rearward, puzzle him. He is also surprised by the extraordinary new success at bridge tournaments of his wife, Ellen. Her mind now seems to have computer-like qualities. With the ingenious help of his attractive cousin, Dr. Lucy Lipscomb, an epidemiologist, he not only uncovers a criminal experiment to improve behavior patterns in the area through the secret use of drugs in the water supply, but he stumbles on a ring of child molesters and pedophiles at Belle Arme, where his children have been sent. On top of this, he is assigned the difficult problem of treating Father Simon Smith, head of the hospice, who has immured himself in a fire tower and refuses to come down. The Thanatos Syndrome is a profoundly serious and often very funny novel, which scans American culture like radar. Walker Percy has been called our cool Dostoevsky, and an interlude in the novel entitled Father Smith's Confession, which demonstrates how easily evil is committed by people convinced they are doing what is right and good, reinforces his claim to this title. Dr. Tom Moore, an old-fashioned physician of the soul, in his seedy seersucker suit, is the life-affirming hero of this splendid novel about life over death. To Robert Coles. The place where the strange events related in this book occur, Feliciana, is not imaginary. It was so named by the Spanish. It was and is part of Louisiana, a strip of pleasant pineland running from the Mississippi River to the Perdido, a curious region of a curious state. Never quite Creole or French or Anglo-Saxon or Catholic or Baptist like other parishes of Louisiana, it has served over the years as a refuge for all manner of malcontents. If America was settled by dissenters from various European propositions, Feliciana was settled by dissenters from the dissent, American Tories who had no use for the Revolution, disgruntled Huguenots and Cavaliers from the Carolinas, New Englanders fleeing from Puritanism, Unionists who voted against secession, Confederate refugees from occupied New Orleans, deserters from the Confederate Army, smugglers from both sides, criminals holed up in the Honey Island swamp. Welcomed in the beginning by the hospitable and indolent Spanish of a decrepit empire, some of these assorted malcontents united long enough to throw out the Spanish and form an independent republic, complete with its own Declaration of Independence, flag, army, navy, constitution, and capital in St. Francisville. The new republic had no inclination to join French Louisiana to the south or the United States to the north, and would as soon have been let alone. It lasted 74 days. Jefferson had bought Louisiana, and that was that. As pleasant a place as its name implies, it still harbors all manner of fractious folk, including Texans and recent refugees from unlikely places like Korea and Michigan, all of whom have learned to get along tolerably well, better than most, in fact, who watch LSU football and reruns of MASH, drink Dixie beer, and eat every sort of food imaginable, which is generally cooked in something called a roux. The downside of Feliciana is that its pine forests have been mostly cut down, its bayous befouled, Lake Pontchartrain polluted, the Mississippi River turned into a sewer. It has too many malls, banks, hospitals, chiropractors, politicians, lawyers, realtors, and condos with names like Chateau Charmant. Still in all, I wouldn't live anywhere else. It is strange, but these Louisianians, for all their differences and contrariness, have an affection for one another. It is expressed by small signs and courtesies, even between strangers, as if they shared a secret. In what follows, the geography of the place has been somewhat scrambled. All of the people in Feliciana have been made up. The only real persons are the German and Austrian professors and physicians who were active in both the Weimar Republic and the Third Reich. Doctors de Krinis, Willinger, Schneider, Nietzsche, Haida, and the Swiss psychiatrist Dr. C.G. Jung. For this information about the Nazi doctors and their academic precursors in the Weimar Republic, I am indebted to Dr. Frederick Wertheim's remarkable book, A Sign for Cain. Walker Percy. The Thanatos Syndrome. Chapter 1. 1. For some time now, I have noticed that something strange is occurring in our region. I have noticed it both in the patients I have treated and in ordinary encounters with people. At first, there were only suspicions. But yesterday, my suspicions were confirmed. I was called to the hospital for a consultation, and there was an opportunity to make an examination. It began with little things, certain small clinical changes which I observed. Little things can be important. Even more important is the ability. Call it knack, hunch, providence, good luck, whatever. To know what you are looking for and to put two and two together. A great scientist once said that genius consists not in making great discoveries, but in seeing the connection between small discoveries. For example, a physician I once knew, not a famous professor or even a very successful internist, but a natural diagnostician, one of those rare birds who sees things out of the corner of his eye, so to speak, and gets a hunch, was going about his practice in New Orleans. He noticed a couple of little things most of us would have missed. He had two patients in the same neighborhood with moderate fever, enlarged lymph nodes, especially in the inguinal region. One afternoon, as he took his...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.